Welcome to CaseWare QuickVids. This QuickVid demonstrates how to specify borders and underlines in tables within financial statements in CaseWare Financials. Borders can be modified from default settings for table headings, and underlines can be specified on table rows. In this video, we will go through both of these procedures. To begin, let's take a look at how we specify the heading border. Note that for this demonstration, I will be using the Financials Canadian template. First, open the financial statement document, then select the format ribbon. Navigate to the table that is to have its header line border changed. In this demonstration, I will be formatting the borders of my statement of equity. Select Header. The border dialog appears. To specify a border for all column headings, click Select All, or click on the specific column for which a heading border is to be defined. Note that any unselected columns will not have heading borders. From the Border Type dropdown, select the type of heading border to use. I will keep the default. From the Line Color dropdown, select the color for the heading borders. I will choose red just so you can see where the changes occur. In the Thickness field, select the thickness of the heading borders. I will keep the default thickness. You can opt to apply the heading border to the top, the middle, or the bottom of the heading. The middle will specify a border between heading rows and does not have any effect on sections that do not have multiple heading rows. I'm going to leave all three checkboxes selected. Click OK when done and the heading borders will update. Now to underline a row. The procedure is similar to specifying a heading border. Click the row you want to underline in the financial statement. I'm going to place an underline under the subtotal row. From the Format ribbon, select Row. The Underline dialog appears. To specify an underline for all columns, click Select All, or click on the specific column for which an underline is to be defined. Again, any unselected columns will not have underlines applied. I will choose the Select All option. Again, select an underline type, color, and thickness. With the row underlines, you'll have the option to select the underline skips. Select this option if you want the underline to appear, even if the row does not print. This is useful if the skip row is the row immediately preceding a subtotal or total. Click OK when done. The row underlines will update. This concludes the QuickVid on underlines in financials. For additional resources, including documentation and online help, see the related links. Thank you for watching CaseWare QuickVids.